I'm just letting everybody in. A very good evening to one and all who's present here. We have this health and fitness workshop today, and we have got a celebrity figure with us, Mr. Sajan Samuel. And let me tell you who he is, which is very important for you all to know. He is an ultra runner, as you all know, but he's also Guinness Book of World Records, Satara Marathon, Berlin Marathon finisher. So the whole issue is there a mantra for fitness? Can we be fit in a period of time? There is a difference between fitness and health. Again, if you want to be slim and fit, depends upon your body metabolism. Do you think people should exercise to slim down or to remain fit? How do I be fit is what people think, as I don't exercise. Is there a diet to be followed is what people question. So we have Mr. Sajan Samuel answering all these questions in the Green Egg Talk. And this is Heart to Heart Chat Show with Ms. Sajan Samuel, and which also bothers people, and he is a celebrity. Sajan Samuel currently works as Vice President, Aptec Limited. He took control of his life at the age of 40, reduced 21 kgs in 3 months, and transitioned to be a long distance runner. Some of his achievements: 161 kilometer thrice in 6 months, which is a wow for me, start to finish time. Best time, 28 hours podium finisher. That's what he says. Run 36 hours at Bangalore Stadium, clocking 185 kilometers. Ran some of the toughest ultras in India. Malnad run of Kutch and Ladakh. I say absolutely wow. Run 650 kilometers inside his house. 65,000 loops. My God, I can't even imagine. 10 meter loop, 29 consecutive days. And this is a record in Indian Book of Records. Staircase climbing 700 floors in 3.03 hours. Squats 2,222 in 1.11 hours. He believes the mind has a power to subvert the body. And once you unlock your mind, amazing things can happen. So let's learn a few tricks from him today. So over to you, Ms. Sajan. I think I've already done the introduction of yours, and everybody is here waiting very eagerly to talk to you, and probably a lot of questions will pop up. We are live on Facebook. We'll have a Zoom group chat here and a live Facebook chat. So please write your questions, and here's here to take it for you. Yeah, Ms. Sajan, sir.
Yeah, first of all, Usha ma'am, thank you.
Comes for to you. I have a very, yes, you can introduce yourself. Then I will have a first question put up to you. Yeah, please introduce.
First of all, Usha ma'am, thank you for this opportunity. And I'm really grateful that I have the pleasure of interacting with all the parents and faculties of the Bangalore School. And Bangalore School is also doing some amazing work. I have been part of many such functions. So I just want to put a context to the entire session, and I would like to share a presentation. And post the presentation, I can deep dive into the nitty-gritties.
Yes.
So I hope you can see my presentation. Is it visible?
Yes, it's visible, Ms. Sajan.
So this was me, this is how I look like, okay, some years back. And this is me again. So this is me, and this is also me. And this is also, at the back, you can see Usha ma'am is there. I am with the mic in the green t-shirt. It's all on me only. And this is how I started my running journey. Nothing about this is right. No form, no technique, no strength, no stamina, nothing. And then one day this happened. This is version 2, Sajan Samuel. So at the age of 41 years, I redefined my life. I took charge of my destiny. I was drifting and ambling like a ship without a rudder. And then I did some good things at the age of 41 years. And this is I ran inside my house for 12 hours continuously, 75 kilometers. So this was covered by Indian Express. I ran 650 kilometers in 29 days inside my house, 10 meter loop, 65,000 loops, average of 22.5 kilometer per day. And around 2,200 squats in 11 minutes. And this is again me. So, what is the place we spend most time? Of course, comfort zone. So I just wanted to put a I just stop this.
Exit the screen. Yeah. And you can come back to talk.
Yeah. So
I must tell you, I met Ms. Sajan Samuel in a cycling marathon. That's where the first time I met you, Ms. Sajan.
Yeah.
So it was like.
Picture is also there.
Yes. And yes. And you were amazing as usual with all your photographers all around you. And you look like a typical celebrity. Now, the first question which you'd like to take is, what is the difference between health and fitness, Ms. Sajan?
Yeah, health is very simply put that if you're not falling sick, if you're having a lower back pain, if you're having some viral fever, then you're not healthy. And if you're visiting the doctor more than once in a month, or if you're falling sick more than once in a month, that means you're not healthy. Okay, fitness is about doing a particular task in a certain cutoff time. Suppose I tell you to run from 1 kilometer, and if you're running that 1 kilometer in 7 minutes or 7.5 minutes, I can say you're fit. But if you're running that 1 kilometer in 10 minutes, I can say you're healthy. So fitness has got a different yardstick to measure. Health means everybody has to stay healthy. So that's a basic difference between health and fitness.
Yes. And how do you manage to do this impossible and physically daunting challenges, which you take it up, which I've been watching it, all these marathons and the cross countries and stuff like that?
So as I showed in the slide that most of us live in the comfort zone, and I think there is no fun in doing the easy things in life. Everybody does the easy thing. The fun is to do the difficult thing, and many people call me crazy. And when people call you crazy, it means you are doing something worthwhile in your life. So it's about unlocking the mind. I think when you unlock your mind and open your mind, our mind is like a parachute. It expands when it opens. So when you unlock your mind, amazing things can happen. Of course, I've trained my body over a period of time. But I was 92 kgs for a long period of my time. And suddenly my health and my life was not at all in my control. But at the age of 37 years, I decided to do something about my health. And when I started to run, I could run barely 500 meters and I was panting for breath. But this sojourn continued for 3 years. I was running 5-6 kilometers and that's all I could run. But one day when I got up from my bed at the age of 40 years, I made a commitment to myself. And that commitment was to transition into India's long distance runner. Such an audacious and lofty dream for a guy weighing 92 kgs at the age of 40 years when people resigned to their fate. You know, that scared me myself. It took myself by surprise that what a lofty commitment I have made. So, but I knew that if I had to be a long distance runner, I need to reduce weight. So I moved into Bombay. I stayed in a slum. I stayed in a slum for 3 months. I slept on the ground, on the hard floor. There was no bed, no refrigerator, no television. I used to sleep at 7 p.m. And when I got up in the middle of the night around 2 o'clock, there was nothing in my house to eat. And I suffered from hunger pangs. I felt like swallowing the bed sheet. And I continued this for 3 months. And also, I was running 70-80 kilometers every week. So my objective was never to reduce weight. Weight reduction was a subset and a byproduct. My objective was always to become a long-distance runner. And I started to enjoy the process. I started falling in love with the process. And because I was hardwired to the process, automatically I reduced weight. So my submission to everybody listening to me is that don't get obsessed with weight reduction. Because if you're reducing weight and if you're not gaining strength, it doesn't make any sense at all. You have to find the process and you have to enjoy that process. So over a period of time, not only did I condition my mind, but also condition my body, also condition my mind. And it's important because long distance running is all about conditioning your mind.
Yes, absolutely. So now, if I ask you, Ms. Sajan, this is a COVID time and people say they've put on weight and they've gained so much of weight. So do you have any diet tips and how to stay immune and stuff like that? So that we don't, because you say that COVID is also, we're just chatting just before the show and you said that COVID is something like flu. So can you just throw light something about that and how to get this immunity, you know, so that we remain immune and we don't catch this cold and cough. And yes. According to you, you said that at one point of time, everybody would have caught COVID. It's a matter of only how people have fought it because of immunity. Yeah.
Yes, sir. We have to treat COVID like a flu, okay? I don't know whether I also had COVID, but I believe that my body immunity is strong. Therefore, COVID might have come and I might have gone. I may not be knowing about it. So I think it is important to stay positive. You know, most of us have this tendency to be shrouded in negativity because there's a lot of negative things going. First of all, reduce screen time. the fact that we are always in our mobile, always in the laptop, always in our television, what are we doing? We're only doing negative news. So reduce screen time. Spend time with yourself. This is the best opportunity to be inward focused, to be reflective, understand as a person who we are and what we want to do. For people who are inward focused, I think it is important to find a new purpose and meaning to their life. Okay? And stick to the basic. Don't change anything. Even before pre-COVID, how you were, remain like that. Imagine that nothing has happened. Okay? And try to surround yourself with positive people. The most essential thing is sleep. You need to sleep minimum 7 hours a day. Because whatever you do, even if you exercise 45 minutes a day, even if you are eating clean, but if you are not sleeping, it's important to sleep. I think everybody should be in the bed by 10 p.m. Early to bed, early to rise, makes a man healthy, wealthy, wise. We all are this. Our grandfathers and grandmothers live for 90 years, 100 years. Why? Because as soon as the sun set, they have finished their dinner. After sunset, they never ate anything. And they used to sleep. Around, they used to sleep early morning, 4 o'clock, they used to get up, they used to work in the farm, they used to pluck the fresh vegetables from the farm, and they used to walk 10 kilometers to school. But what happened? When we become rich, we become more lazier. आपने कभी गरीब को मोटा देखा है क्या? कोई गरीब आदमी को मोटा होते देखा है? गरीब पतला ही रहता है. तो वो बर्गर, पिज्जा, फ्राई और ये सब खाता नहीं है. The maximum sale which has happened in this 3 months is Maggie. Sale of Maggie has gone through the roof. Because people are finding comfort in food. लोगों को लगता है कि खाने में ही दवा है. खाना खा लो, ज्यादा खाना खा लो. It's not true. I only have 2 meals a day. And I run 80 kilometers a week. So I think is we eat more because by nature we are bhookad. हमको खाने में हमको मजा आता है. So don't binge watch. Okay, don't have watch too much television, too much OTT, too much Netflix. Channelize your energy. The golden mantra is: before sunset, stop eating. 6:30 p.m. should be your last meal. Add 3-4 glasses of water. What I do, I have instead of coffee, I have ginger water. So I put ginger in boiled water and I drink it. Twice in a day, boost immunity. I do clean eating. I eat only homemade food, no aerated drinks, no juice. I stopped sugar 4 years back. So no white sugar because white sugar spikes up your insulin level. And no cakes, no pastry. Try to avoid sweet. Try to avoid the deep fried items. Have homemade food because you can control what is happening in your kitchen. Exercise to 1 hour a day. हम लोग क्या है हम लोग एक कुर्सी में बैठ जाते हैं तो देन आवर स्पाइन द सेकंड बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम आफ्टर कॉमन कोल्ड इज स्पाइन प्रॉब्लम एवरीबॉडी हैज अ लोअर बैक स्पाइन प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज़ यू आर स्लाउचिंग इन द चेयर फॉर आई डोंट नो हाउ मेनी आवर्स सो इंस्टेड ऑफ सिटिंग वी कैन डू वॉकिंग वी कैन टेलीफोन वी कैन वॉक वी कैन डू आवर मेल्स आल्सो बाय वॉकिंग वी कैन वॉच टेलीविजन वॉकिंग रीड अ बुक बिकॉज रीडिंग अ बुक यू नो स्टिमुलेट्स योर माइंड Make real connections instead of sitting on the virtual world. We all like validation. अरे हमने एक पोस्ट किया कितना लोगों ने लाइक किया ज्यादा लोगों ने लाइक किया तो हम टेंशन में आ जाते हैं हमारा पोस्ट को ज्यादा We are living in a world of likes and shares. Just get real. Pick up the phone, talk to people, you know, make real connections in the world. I think move away from this virtual world and just ape and follow our grandfather and grandmothers. And remember, our grandmothers used to tell us stories and how nicely we used to sleep. Today, when our kids come and tell us, Mummy, Mummy, kahani bolo. We say, beta, ye mobile lo, ja ke khud dekh lo, jo dekhna hai. We have lost the art of storytelling only. We don't know how to put our kids to sleep. I think let's take some good things from the past. Of course, I'm not telling that we have to, you know, now live in the past. Take something from the past and see what is the present, but don't get boggled about the future. I can assure you the world is not going to end. We are going to survive this. Okay. Don't get boggled about future mein kya hoga, kya hoga. Live in the moment, live in the present. And I'm telling you that you will not only stay safe, but you will also stay healthy.
Yes. Thank you. They say health is wealth. Can you see at the back of Ms. Sajan, there are a lot of medals hanging. And that's how his pride is all the medals, what he has got it. And that's because of the fitness level, what he has, and the kind of the stamina he has. He says you need to have a good stamina, to fight anything. whether it's COVID or no COVID, you need to have a good stamina. Now, Ms. Sajan, there's a question from the parents, from the people who have told me to ask you in this particular session. They said that they've been advising people to do yoga. And they also said you need to do meditation and yoga because that's the only way to overcome kind of depression. People are feeling very frustrated and depressed because they are just sitting in the house and they're not doing, they're not going out. They're not doing much. And how to fight depression and how to fight this frustration? Do you think yoga and meditation is the only thing, or do you think anything else apart from that to do to overcome depression?
I think yoga and meditation are one of the many things. Of course, there are many other things we can do. Yoga helps in slowing time. Okay, it helps you to live in the moment and not linger in the past or worry about your future. Meditation is very important for everybody. Meditation means just switching off, staying disconnected from the world and immersing in your own self. It is very important to understand who we are and what we want to do in our life. Because most of the time, we are living in this rigmarole of a frenzied, agitated life, but we never have a pause button. Our life is always fast forward. So it's important to step back, pause, and ask ourselves some pertinent questions. And trust me, the answer to all the questions lie within ourselves. So apart from yoga, which one can do, you can also do a lot of floor exercises. I myself have never gone to a gym in my last so many years. I think people go to gym to take selfies and post on Facebook. Okay, it's a waste of money. I think you can do floor exercises. You can do simple skipping, you can do. Okay, you can just walk around in the house. And I'm telling you that even if you have to go to buy something vegetable from the neighborhood, please walk and go. We have this habit of taking our car even to go to the loo. And the day we moved from Indian commode to Western toilet, we embrace laziness. Okay?
Yes. We have a question for you, Ms. Sajan. And the question says that, the question is this: how can we control the appetite? I'm fond of sweets and snacks. It's what Subhashree says. So how do you control that?
Subhashree, I can understand what you're going through. I used to just love sweets. When I used to travel to Calcutta, I used to have 500 grams of Mishida in one shot. I used to gorge on sweets. But one day I made a commitment to myself that, look, this sweet is not helping me. I used to have a lot of digestion problem. I used to have a lot of problem. What happens is that, अभी तो सब ठीक है लेकिन व्हाटएवर मनी भी है हमारा लाइफ ऐसा है हम पहले 50 साल तक बहुत कमाते हैं फिर 50 साल से 70 साल हम पैसा को लेकर डॉक्टर के पास जाते हैं डॉक्टर साहब आप ले लो आप बचाओ मेरे को बीपी है कोलेस्ट्रॉल है हार्ट अटैक आप ले लो तो फायदा क्या हुआ इतना सेल्फ भागने पैसे के पीछे भागने का इन्वेस्टमेंट इन हेल्थ इज द ओनली थिंग विच इज गोइंग टू गिव यू गारंटेड रिजल्ट आप मैं ये नहीं बोल रहा आप सीट बंद कर दो आप कम करो अगर आपको चार रोटी आपका प्लेट में है तो हमको दो रोटी काफी हमारा भूख मिटाने लेकिन हम पांच रोटी खाते हैं हैव ओनली 80% ऑफ व्हाट यू रिक्वायर अब 80% से ज्यादा मत खाइए स्वीट ऑल्सो रिड्यूस इट बिकॉज स्वीट इज बेसिकली शुगर एंड व्हाट हैपेंस विद शुगर इज दैट इट डायरेक्टली गोज इन टू योर हार्ट इट इज इंसुलिन इट स्पाइक्स अप योर इंसुलिन लेवल एंड व्हाट हैपेंस ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम कोलेस्ट्रॉल प्लेस गेट बिल्डिंग अप इन योर आर्टरी एंड योर आर्टरी गेट्स ब्लॉक एंड दैट इज हाउ कार्डियक अरेस्ट हैपेंस कार्डियक अरेस्ट इज नॉट Something is happening on a particular day. It is compounded. It is happening over several years. Today also, what is the mothers are packing lunch boxes for the children? Leher, kurkure, magic masala. We have packed karke dete hai bachchon ko khane ke liye. Okay, and we are having vada pav. We are having biscuit. Hum chai mein duba ke biscuit khate. But that biscuit is not good for health. Please understand that biscuit is maida. It is carbs. So this you have to understand the science of nutrition. Most people do not understand the science. Unko bhook lagta hai to jo milta hai kha lete hai. Aisa nahi kar sakte hai. See, our body is an engineering marvel. Main aapko ek example deta hu. Aapne ek Mercedes Benz gaadi khareed liya. To aapko gaadi ke liye aap ek chauffeur rakhega. You will ensure wheel balancing and alignment. You will ensure tire rotation. You will ensure that vehicle is getting serviced periodically. Our body is like that. There is something in our body called visceral fat. Many of us do not even know कि हमारा body में क्या क्या organ है अब लोगों से पूछा आपका gall bladder किधर तुम्हारे यार किधर है मेरा gall bladder किधर है मेरा pancreas what does intestine do अरे बस you know about the vehicle हमको अपना गाड़ी के बारे में सब मालूम है clutch किधर है brake किधर है वो accelerator किधर लेकिन अपना body के बारे में कुछ पता नहीं है so my submission to everybody is that do a blood test and that blood test should happen every 6 months you must know your cholesterol, your lipid profile, your triglyceride, your sugar level, your BP. Because if you do not know what is your current position, you will not be able to then progress on and find remedies for that. So please, everybody do a blood test. Every 6 months, do a blood test, just like we give. Our body is not our car. Understand this. Our body is not our bungalow. This is the biggest our health. So our body should also be taken care of. Our body should also not be abused. And instead of what people do, log fruits lete hain fir usko juice banate hain. Bas aap juice kyon bana rahe ho? Fruit ko kaccha khao aap. Because once you are converting a fruit into the juice, all the essential macronutrients of the fruit is going away. And I can have one apple, right? And to make a juice, I need 3 apples. Imagine the amount of sugar. So when you are having a fruit, what happens? One, you are eating in the raw form. Second, sugar, does not have sugar. It has a substance called fructose. And fructose goes into the insulin very, very slowly it goes. It is also accompanied by nutrients. So instead of juice, have fruit. People ask me, yes, white sugar ka badle hum brown sugar kha sakte hain. But white sugar, brown sugar paint kiya hua hai wo. The answer to no sugar is no sugar. The answer to no sugar is not brown sugar. Yeah, sugar free. Aisa kuch nahi, aisa hota nahi hai. There is no substitute for water. Agar aapko pyaas lag raha to pani pijiye. Pyaas lag raha to lassi mat pijiye dukaan se. Pyaas lag raha to Coca Cola, Pepsi mat pijiye. That is all has got zilch nutritional value. That is all sugar. So you just have plain water. Sometimes you can have a coconut water. That's it. But and cigarette. Please, for heaven's sake, stop smoking. Because every time you smoke one cigarette, it increases your chance of heart attack by 50%.
Yes, for sure. So the next question for you, Ms. Sajan, is what is the best way to motivate to start exercising? Mind says to do it, but body says just doesn't agree. And the same person has asked that, is there any truth that eating rice increases the weight, but we South Indians cannot live without rice? Same person has asked this. These both questions.
Yeah, so I will answer the first question first. They're saying that mind is saying yes and body is saying no. So I say you break it into small target. First target is to get up, sleep late, sleep early. Everything starts from sleeping early. You have to switch off all your work. Your mobile phone should be switched off 1 hour before sleep. If you are sleeping at 10 p.m., your mobile should be switched off by 9 p.m. You should switch off your mobile. Okay? And then first target is sleep early. Because and give small milestones. So when you and if you sleep early, you'll get up early. That is second target. If you get up early, then step out of the house, go for a walk. So break it up into small targets. Okay. And then what happens? Then you will start loving that. I can assure everybody that once you take charge of your health, your energy levels will be high. There is going to be a new positivity around you. You are going to also energy is infectious, so you're also going to resonate and radiate positivity around. Your life will be in control. This is also going to have a direct relationship with your professional and personal life. So you have to ask yourself this question here. Should I go to doctor after 5 years? And then when you go to doctor, what will happen? Doctor aapko bolega, nahi sir, aapko ye problem hai, ye scan karo, wo scan karo, then you will find 10 other problems. Bahut log, many people don't go to blood test because unko lagta hai yaar blood test karne gaya to bahut sara bimari nikal ke aayega. Aisa nahi hai. So the only way to ensure that body and mind both agrees is to break it up into small targets. That is the only way you can do it. And second, and what is the other question?
The question was that eating rice, it increases the weight. So, but we South Indians cannot be without rice. So what do we do? What is the substitute for rice?
What is important?
Abraham is asking this question.
What is important? Rice is important or your life is important? That is a question you have to ask yourself. My life is more important than the rice. See, there is no harm in having rice. Make no mistake. But rice is carbs. Okay. And if what is the function of carb? Carb is nothing but energy stored in your body. And you need carbs only when you're doing some heavy exercises or when you're doing some bodybuilding or something like that. Our body has already enough fat is there. Agar hum 2 din bhi nahi khayega to hamara body ka andar excess fat already store kiya hua hai, our body picks up that fat. So I don't think that rice eating, especially in the evening, avoid it. Okay, If you go for rice, go for brown rice. I don't take rice at all. I have stopped rice many years back because it is carb. Move from carb to protein. I have lot of vegetables in your diet. I have lot of fruits and I have nuts. The problem, what happens is the snack time. एक बजे लंच करते हैं हम लोग, फिर हमको चार बजे पांच बजे के बीच में भूख लगता है बहुत जोर से, फिर हमको जो मिलता है हम खा लेते हैं, समोसा खा लेते हैं, वड़ा पकाते हैं, पकौड़ा खा लेते हैं. That is a wrong thing. Don't avoid that. Don't have that different item. So if you are feeling that hungry, have a yoga bar. Okay, yoga bar you get in Amazon. That is also a protein substitute. You can have that. That is sugarless. That is tasteless. Or you have nuts. You can have walnut. You can have cashew nut. You can have peanut. Have some nuts. And have green tea if possible. But green tea is not the magic bullet. Log kya karte hai? Samosa khate hai, phir green tea peete hai. Usse koi fayda nahi hai. So I'll give an example how this works. You go to a gym and you burn out 600 calories. And on the way, you step into McDonald's and you have a burger and a cappuccino. Going to gym was of no use. Health and nutrition are two independent pillars. They are not mutually exclusive. So, आप जितना भी एक्सरसाइज करेंगे लेकिन आप उल्टा फुल्टा खाएगा तो आप पतला नहीं होगा. 80% is in the diet and 20% exercise. आप बहुत कम खाएंगे और एक्सरसाइज नहीं करेंगे तो आपका बॉडी कमजोर हो जाएगा. Your body will become weak. You will not have any strength. So what happens? You will be losing muscle mass also in your body. It is important to ensure that your body, when you do a blood test, it will show you how much fat is there in your body and how much muscle is there in your body. So you also need to build strength. You need to build muscle in your body. After every 10 years, our muscles decay by 10%. Why do people have joint problems, especially people at the age of 50s having knee problem? They're having lower back problems because there has been no mobility. Gaadi garage mein pada hua tha. तो गाड़ी गैराज में पड़ा होगा तो आप बहुत साल बाद निकला तो क्र 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 आवाज करेगा तो हमारा जॉइंट भी ऐसा हो गया. तो स्टार्ट वॉकिंग, स्टार्ट बिकमिंग मोर फिजिकली एक्टिव. इंस्टेड ऑफ टेकिंग द कार, टेक योर साइकिल आउटसाइड. आई एम सेइंग बी फिजिकली एक्टिव. इवन इफ यू आर अवॉइड लिफ्ट स्टार्ट टेकिंग द स्टेयरकेस. जस्ट मेक सिंपल सटल चेंजेस इन योर लाइफस्टाइल. ईट क्लीन, हैव गुड स्लीप एंड आई थिंक यू विल live a very, very healthy life.
I think it's a very, very simple mantra. Yeah. It's a simple mantra which he has told us today. He said, eat simple and live simple. Switch off your mobile phones, which is not possible by us, for sure. But he's telling you also that you need to have a little bit of fitness in your life by just, you know, climbing up steps instead of taking the lift and probably using cycles. And also our food matters a lot. And probably he will tell us how much of rice we should eat because we all are South Indians and we love rice. And you should not overload yourself where you're supposed to take 4 chapatis. He's asking us to take 2 chapatis and limit yourself as far as sweet is concerned. So I think we got all that basic things for the adults. But can you throw light, Mr. Sajan, and tell the parents also out here? And of course, there are... people here who have got children, you can just tell them like what could the children eat. You know, basically children gorge on chocolates. They love chocolates and they also eat popcorns at erratic time. And they also say salt should not be eaten after specific time. Sweet should not be given to children after certain time because they urinate in the bed and stuff like that. So just throw light and what kind of a diet should children have between 2 years to 6 years?
Yeah, I think it's very difficult to control child, okay? Because I have also 2 daughters, they never listen to me, okay? They only eat what they feel like. So it is very difficult for in today's parents to control their life. But I will just give an example to you. What we do whenever there is a vacation, we take our children and take them to some exotic place. Malaysia leke jaate, Singapore leke jaate, aur wahan ka chaka chon dikhate. My humble request to parents is that when next time is a vacation, take them to a farm. Show them how the milk is milked from a cow. Show them how cow dungs are made. Let them see the grassroots reality of Indian culture and Indian farms. Rather than taking to exotic locations in Thailand and Bangkok. I think, and many cases, parents will have to lead the example. An occasional chocolate here and there is not a problem at all because we don't want to deprive them of all these things. Occasional thing is fine, but don't make that the norm. Anything homemade food is good. Whatever is made at the home is good. Avoid fast food. Avoid food which is processed, packaged, and preserved. avoid that. But ready-made food jo hota hai, humne dukaan se khareed liya, because we do not check nutritional labels. When we check nutritional labels, we will know. Like you buy, I'll just give an example to you. WHO, World Health Organization's mandate in 2015 is 25 grams of sugar is a recommended intake of sugar per day. And that is includes intrinsic sugar also. That is also sugar which is there from cereals. But how many of us follow that? We don't follow that. So it's important to that your children also follows an active lifestyle and let them encourage them to play a sport. They can play table tennis, they can play badminton. Let them just go and fall down. Okay, what happens? Bachcha bhagte hai to mother jaake pakad ke usko god mein baithate hai. Kyun? Maa ko bhi bhagna padega iske liye. Let the child run, let the child fall, because that is how they are. They are fearless. They will fall, they will get some few cuts here and there. And when they grow up, they will be fearless. When you hold that child and stop him from running, that child then becomes very shy. And then the shy bachcha ko lagta hai bhagna galat hai. And then bachcha becomes introvert. Aur zindagi bhar waisa rahega. Ab usko chhod do, gir ke do. Jab tak girega nahi, do teen cut, thoda thoda scar nahi hoga. They will not be brave. So I think parents should just let the child be themselves, be expressive. And over a point of time, you cannot control children because they are in their own world. They live in their own world. Occasional chocolate, occasional intelligence, ice cream and all that is fine. But try to make homemade ice creams. Whatever you are trying to buy from a restaurant or from a store, cook it at home. That is my suggestion.
That's a very good suggestion. So you got it, parents out there. Children can be given chocolates, but it can be occasional. And here we've got a question from Poonam Puni from Facebook chat. Which is more effective, exercising in the morning or evening? And time gap required between food and exercise. So can you throw light on that, Ms. Sajan?
I follow a process of 8 a.m. breakfast. I have my lunch at 12 p.m. I have my last meal at 4 p.m. Then I am on intermittent fasting for 16-17 hours. I don't need anything except water. Okay. Exercising in the morning is the best thing because in the morning, your body and mind are actively engaged and you can get optimum result. In the evening, your energy levels come down. Your mind and body are not receptive to welcome whatever exercises you do. And you have to get up in the morning at 6 o'clock. Minimum 6 o'clock. I get up at 4 o'clock. Every single day, I've been getting at 4 a.m. in the morning. And I start running at 5 o'clock. I run 4 days a week. So you can run at 6 o'clock or you can exercise at 6 o'clock. And try to, even before run exercise, try to have a light snack. That depends upon your body. I only have a black coffee. I come back and have I mix lime water with glucose and rock salt and I have my drink. So after my exercise, I have my breakfast only after 1 hour. I don't immediately have my breakfast. And my breakfast is the same for last 4 years. I have not changed my breakfast at all. It is the same breakfast. And my wife is also the same for the last 4 years. And my breakfast is also the same. So don't tamper too much with your diet. Occasional, of course, you can have some intelligence here and there. But everybody's bodies are unique. So it is very difficult for me to tell you what diet you should follow because that is your body. The best diet is the diet which you can sustain for your entire lifetime.
She's also asking one more from you. She's saying, any suggestions for thyroid patients and any specific rules for walking?
Nothing. So walk. So in the beginning, start walking in the beginning. Don't procrastinate. Start walking. Everything starts in the beginning. Again, I'm going back and telling you, everything starts from sleeping time. If you are hitting bed at 11:30 p.m., you are not going to get up at 5 o'clock. You may get up at 5 o'clock, then you will again fall asleep in the afternoon. You have to have 7 hours of sleep. So my recommended time for sleep for every parent is 10 p.m. And apne bachchon ko bhi aadat dalo ki 10 baje light switch off ho jana chahiye. Ghar ka pura light switch off ho jana chahiye. 10 baje sona hai. 5 o'clock ko aapko uthna hai. Then you can do walking at 5:30 a.m. onwards. Early morning is the best. In the beginning, walk slowly because you are probably not walked for so many. And that is such a paradox, right? I'm telling, when we grew up, we were walking at the age of 2 years and we're falling down. Now we are asking that walk up kaise karna hai. So after 50 years, we are discovering how to walk. No? That's a little paradox. So people puchte hai ki running kaise karte hai. Running is a natural form of human evolution. Agar aag lagta hai, to hum sabse tez bhagega. Usin bolt bhi fail ho jayega. Or if a black dog chases us in the morning, we'll be running so fast. So it's a paradox. But walk slowly. Don't be patient and spend more time outside. Look at more time being spent outside than how much distance you have walked. And gradually increase your stamina. Let your body get accustomed to your new lifestyle. What is my take is that adopt and embrace a healthy lifestyle. When you are adopting and embracing a healthy lifestyle, everything comes underneath. Weight reduction, everything, all comes under the ambit of embracing a healthy lifestyle. So, walk slowly, gradually increase the pace. And thyroid, as if your sab bimari dur bhag jayega. Main aapko likhit mein, I can 100 rupees stamp paper mein, notarized stamp paper mein aapko likh ke guarantee ka saath, dawa ka saath likh ke de sakta hu ki aapka sab bimari bhag jayega if you are adopting a healthy lifestyle. आप कोई डॉक्टर के पास जाएगा वो आपको दुनिया भर का स्कैन करके दे देगा कुछ होने वाला नहीं है उससे योर हेल्थ इज इन योर कंट्रोल यू आर द ड्राइवर एंड द स्टीयरिंग व्हील इज इन योर कंट्रोल यू हैव टू ड्राइव द व्हीकल सो टेक कंट्रोल ऑफ योर हेल्थ
एंड यू हैव अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम प्रीतम शी सेज टीनेज चिल्ड्रन सिट विद स्टडीज एंड होमवर्क एंड थैंक्स टू लॉकडाउन डज नॉट मूव आउट ऑफ द हाउस Can you suggest something for them? Like they always have excuse that we have to study, we have to do homework, but they don't do exercise. So how do we motivate them to go out and or in the house to do exercise? That's what she says.
Yeah, I know, ma'am, whoever has asked me the question, I know it's a very, very difficult question to answer. There is no straightforward answer. How do we control today's children? That itself, we will have to have a separate seminar and Usha ma'am has to get some experts for that because children don't listen. आप डंडा मारेगा तो रूम में बंद अपने आप को बंद कर देगा आप उसको प्यार से बोलेगा तो आप सुनेगा नहीं दैट डे व्हेन आई वाज ग्रोइंग अप इफ यू वांटेड टू कम्युनिकेट समथिंग टू माय फादर आई विल कम्युनिकेट टू माय मदर बिकॉज़ सो अफ्रेड टू फेस माय फादर टुडे व्हेन द फादर कम्स होम एंड सेज हाय बेटा देन द डॉटर सेज द सन सेज हां क्या हुआ मैं मोबाइल में गेम खेल रहा हूं तो बहुत डिफिकल्ट हो गया कि पेरेंट्स को कैसे काउंसिल करना अपने बच्चों को यार एक्सरसाइज करो लाइफस्टाइल चेंज करो I think it's very difficult for me to answer, but one thing is a lead by example. आप खुद अगर वो शुरू करेंगे तो धीरे 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 वो आपको देख के वो भी शुरू करेगा और वंस व्हेन यू वर्किंग आउट यू टेल योर किड ज्वाइन मी बेटा मेरे को ज्वाइन करो आप भी थोड़ा स्किप करो वो ऐसा ही हो सकता है इट्स अ वेरी वेरी टीडियस एंड स्लो प्रोसेस देयर इज नो मैजिक बुलेट कि आप आज बोलेंगे तो उनको खुद सोचना चाहिए कि मेरे को करना है और जब तक वो खुद अंदर से नहीं सोचेगा ये होने वाला नहीं
So what he's trying to tell you is, it's the willpower which counts. So now we have Ms. Atika Mohan asking, good evening, sir. How to encourage my kid aged 5 to eat vegetables? For instance, she will say brinjal is slime and refuse to eat and all that stuff. She gives a lot of excuses. So how to overcome that?
Again, there is no straightforward answer.
I think you need to switch on your light, Ms. Sajan, because
hold on.
Your picture, yeah. I will change your position so that we can. Yeah, that's much better. You're visible.
Yeah, so I think there is again no straightforward answer to it. Okay, how to make the child take vegetables or fruits or any for that matter, anything. You have to slowly understand that your child. You have to get more personal with your child. Understand what they enjoy, and you have to try different options. That is the only way, I think so. Because I also have two daughters and it is very difficult for me. I also have the same challenges of trying to persuade them. I tried persuading them. I tried influencing them. I tried motivating them. I've never succeeded with them. Let me be honest with you. Okay. And the days of shouting at the kid or scolding or rebuking doesn't work at all. And I, even though their father is an ultra runner and very fit, but my kids are just opposite to me. So it's very, very difficult for me to answer this question. I can only say one thing. You have to die trying. Keep on trying. One day better sense will prevail.
So try, keep trying. That's what he says. Till you are successful in doing that. But what Ms. Sajan says is, whatever we want to do it with our kids, we need to set with examples. So if we do that, they follow the leader. Now we have one question for you, Ms. Sajan. Is it okay to cleanse your body by fasting from time to time? What kind of food during fast and post fasting can be consumed? How to encourage my kid to eat vegetables? This question has come from the Facebook chat.
See, intermittent fasting was always there from grandfather's era. एक हमने एक नया नया उसको एक वर्ड दे दिया, ग्लैमरस सेक्सी वर्ड दे दिया, इंटरमिटेंट फास्टिंग। ये पहले ही था, ये 100 साल से आईएफ चल रहा है। लोग जंगल में जब रहते थे तो क्या खाने को थे? सो आई थिंक दैट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आईएफ विंडो ऑफ आईएफ इज फ्रॉम 12 hours to 18 hours, दैट इज अ विंडो। सो यू कैन स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 12 o'clock to 12 hours फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल। तो आप 6 बजे से 6 बजे तक कर सकते हो या 8 बजे से 8 बजे तक कर सकते हो। 8 PM और आई थिंक द रिकमेंडेड इज 7 PM आइडियल टाइम। लास्ट मील शुड बी 7 PM टिल 7 AM 12 hours। स्टार्ट विद 12 hour आईएफ एंड ग्रेजुअली इंक्रीज। सो आफ्टर 7 PM यू आफ्टर योर डिनर यू कांट डू एनीथिंग इन बिटवीन। खाली पानी पी सकते हो, यू कांट हैव ग्रीन टी ऑल्सो, नथिंग यू कैन हैव। एंड देन नेक्स्ट डे मॉर्निंग 7 o'clock यू कैन हैव योर ब्रेकफास्ट। Once your body gets adapted to the lifestyle, increase that 12-hour window to 13, then 14, then 15. The maximum is 18. Fasting, I will never recommend. Fasting is a shortcut, is a disaster. It's a perfect recipe for disaster. Because you will lose weight soon and you will gain weight soon. You will not be able to sustain your weight. Never do fasting at all. Vegetables are absolutely important because vegetable contains macronutrients, it contains amino acid, it contains all sorts of nutritional value food. If you have a popcorn and you have a broccoli, both have same calorie but both have different nutritional value. A broccoli has very high nutritional value. So try to have these sort of vegetables which has high nutritional value. Carrot you can boil and have, beetroot you can have. Eat vegetables, fresh vegetables, because vegetables add nutrition, have fruits in the raw form, and there may be some food which we all like. Somebody may like jackfruit, somebody may like mango, somebody may like watermelon. Have it in the raw form. Vegetables, have plenty of vegetables. And how do you, why should you have vegetables? How do you convince yourself to have vegetables? Because that is a very good source to build your energy up at optimal level. You eat fast food, what happens with fast food is that there's a lot of trans fat, okay? And energy levels come down, immunity becomes low. Especially during COVID times, it is very important to keep your immunity at very, very high level, okay? And for that, you have to have eat clean, absolutely eat clean. So stop ordering from Swiggy and Zomato, first of all. Stop ordering. Khana ghar pe banao. That is the first advice I want to give everybody.
That's very nice. So you need to be eating home food and home cooked food and not eat the outside food is what Ms. Sajan recommends. But Ms. Sajan, this is a question from my side. Like, we never go for a health checkup. We always think we are healthy because we are carrying on with our work. And when we suddenly find that we have some kind of issue, so we go to the doctor. How often do you recommend health checkups? And second thing is, when the doctor recommends a certain kind of medicines, do you think consuming that and after that, you know, our lifestyle doesn't change and stuff like this? And probably what I try to say is, like, we have stopped laughing. We've stopped doing small thing which actually can keep us fit. So recommend or like throw light on what could be done to avoid, you know, leading to major things like blood pressure and kind of thing like sugar problem and all suddenly which people have. And secondly, like, how often should we go for a health checkup?
See, I'll tell you about my, as I told you about myself, I was 92 kgs, my life was not in control and I was having a everything under the sun. My favorite food was chicken popcorn milk from KFC. Okay. And then one day I all the consequences started to happen and then I took charge of my life. I think health checkup should be happen once in 6 months. It is imperative. It's not optional at all. The most important thing in this world is our health. There is nothing more important than that. Your work can stop. Everything can stop, but your health cannot stop. You have to do health checkup once in 6 months. Okay. The mantra is very simple. You go to a doctor, he will only ask you 4 questions. Aap exercise karte ho, aap cigarette peete ho, aap kya khana khate ho. Wo bhi aapko shuru mein 3 sawal puchega, uska baad apna stethoscope leke aapko diagnosis karega. But first he will ask these 3 questions. 61% of India's life disease is through lifestyle disease. 61% of our death is because of lifestyle. A cardiac arrest happens because of lifestyle disease. Creatinine level in kidney goes up because of lifestyle disease. Cholesterol, lifestyle disease. Understand your BMI. I know everybody understands their BMI and everybody knows what is lipid profile. If your waistline is above 37 for men, you have a problem. If your heart rate, which is your resting heart rate, is about between 90 to 100, you have a problem. If you are climbing 6 floors and you are panting for breath, you have a problem. Okay, don't delay it because one day this is a ticking time bomb. आपको पता भी नहीं चलेगा और ये बम फट जाएगा. Because all these health diseases are compounded. It never happens in a single day. It happens over a period of time. I'll give a simple example. पाइप है घर पे, सबका घर पे पाइप पे हम खोलते हैं, तो अगर वो पाइप में क्या होता है, जंग बढ़ जाते हैं और वो पाइप लीक करते हैं, राइट? वो जंग एक दिन में नहीं बढ़ते, सालों 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 से जंग बढ़ता रहता है. देन व्हाट हैपेंड, अगर वो पाइप को बैंडेज लगाएगा तो एक ना एक दिन वो पाइप फट जाएगा. इट विल नॉट बी द सेम पाइप. आवर हार्ट इज वर्किंग ओवर टाइम. आप जितना जंक खाना खाएगा आपका हार्ट ओवर टाइम काम कर रहा है. यू आर वन डे cannot take the brunt and the heart collapses and that is how you have cardiac arrest. All youngsters, earlier heart attack was happening for people above 60 and 70. Now heart attack is happening for even people under 30 years of age. Make no mistake, pehle tak kudrat hamara khyal rakhega 40 saal ko umar tak. Kudrat aapka khyal nahi rakhega. Kudrat is already showing his wrath on everybody. Okay, there is no age for you to go to heaven. Okay, but I think, and if you look at spine, when we are youngsters, our spine is straight. And when we are with age, our spine becomes like this. Why? Because mobility nahi hai. Joint mein pain hai, ghutno mein dard hai, isme dard hai, usme dard hai. Ye because lifestyle hamara waisa laziness ho gaya. Gaadi humne khareed liya, air condition gaadi khareed liya, air condition ghar hai hamara, fir hamara driver hai, fir hamara naukar hai, fir hamara chakar hai, fir hamara body kidhar hil raha hai, kuch bhi nahi kar raha hai. There's no movement in our body at all. If you go to a neighborhood store also, hum gaadi nikalega, scooter nikala. So we are not moving our body. How many of you have just, see what I did, I went to Ladakh last year and got lost in the wilderness for 15 days. How many of us has gone to nature, switched off our phone and just left everything for 15 days and get lost? I'm saying that just get lost in the wilderness and discover yourself. Mobile is a good thing. It is doing many good things for us. But we have got married to technology. And technology has pervaded our lives. We should know when to switch off this mobile. And when we should know when to switch it on. I think it's time that we get real. We think about ourselves. And make health a priority.
Now, there's one question for you, Ms. Sajan. It says, is it okay to tempt the kid with a pizza to feed for a broccoli, homemade, although the base is ready-made, all-purpose flour dough? I mean, for the sake of one healthy food, compromise on the other part or something like that, so that to tempt the child to eat broccoli. So is it good to do that?
See, I don't think we should try and tempt the child, because the child is not like a fish now when you are throwing a bait. So I think that I don't know with child what works, whether logic reasoning works, whether emotion works, whether blackmailing works. I really don't know, because I have not succeeded with both my daughters. So I probably made me the wrong person to answer it. But I can only give you one answer to this. You know, take our children to farms. Take our children one day and stay in a village. Let our child sit on top of a tractor and see how harvesting is being done. Let our child see how cow's milk is getting milked. Let our child see a farm life. We have given our child all comfort. You know what, from where we got our values? We got our values because we were very poor. We were born in very poor families. Okay, my father did not give me a cycle to play with. And that gave me values. I'm not telling that because you're rich, there is no values. But our child is not going through the hardship and struggle what we have gone through in our life. It is important to give hardship and struggle to a life. Ek chocolate mangte hai, tum do deta hai. हम बच्चे को बोलते हैं, बेटा तू 90% मार्क्स लेके आएगा तो हम तुमको गाड़ी खरीद के देगा. दिस इज अ प्रॉब्लम. व्हाट आर वी डूइंग? वी आर गिविंग देम रॉन्ग वैल्यूज.
वन मोर क्वेश्चन इज, डस लाइम हनी एंड वाटर हेल्प अस रिड्यूस? इज इट अ मिथ और डस इट रियली रिड्यूस आवर वेट?
All this has not helped to reduce your weight. Don't get obsessed with weight reduction. That's what I told you in the beginning itself. I am telling everybody, get married to the process. Okay? All the three pillars should come and work in tandem. Health, nutrition and sleep. You cannot tamper with each other. Aapne sab kuch kiya lekin aap 7 ghanta soye nahi, to it just get wasted. Complete waste. You have to see what is health is. Health is about being happy from within. You have to be happy. Agar aap patla ho gaye lekin ab andar se kamzor hai, aap dukhi hai, aapke andar mein tanav hai, to kya fayda hoga weight kam karke? Weight reduction should make you strong, appear and it should radiate happiness and positivity to others. It is very holistic. It is not like kali weight kam karna hai mera 80 kilo hai mere ko abhi 60 kilo banna hai mere ko acha acha kapda pehenna hai mere ko apna figure dikhana hai. It is wrong process. You will never sustain it. You will never be able to sustain it. If that is cannot be the objective at all. That is a floating goal. The real objective is about adapting a lifestyle which is sustainable for a long period of time. And you have to enjoy the process. You cannot short circuit the process and cannot fix outcome. I never fix an outcome. Mujhe 20 kilo kam karna hai. Because I love that process. I enjoy the process. Automatically that happened as a byproduct.
Yes, absolutely. What Sajan says is there's no shortcut to be successful and to be fit. That's what he says. So let's follow this mantra of saying that weight need not be reduced, but you need to be fit and with a proper breakfast, proper kind of a diet and proper intake of water. And of course, walk should be part of the life and probably laugh it out loud so that, you can overcome all this kind of myth saying lime, honey and water can really, bring down our weight and stuff like this. There's a question for you, Mr. Sajan. And it says, what is the ideal breakfast, lunch and dinner time for kids ages 2 and 5? And my kid loves fruits, but doesn't eat vegetables. How to compensate the nutrition?
So I think the ideal time for breakfast should be 8 o'clock. The ideal time for lunch should be anywhere between 12 o'clock.
Child should be able to get up at 8 o'clock, no, Mesh Sajan. Children are getting up very erratic time.
So that is because they are not sleeping at 10 p.m. They have to sleep at 10 p.m. And parents should tell them stories. The best, easiest way to put a kid to sleep is by telling stories. You tell a kid a story, they will sleep immediately. But we have lost the art of storytelling. Imagine India as a culture of mythology. And traditionally, we have been so powerful in storytelling. But we have lost the art of storytelling because we are married to our devices.
Art of storytelling.
So we have to tell stories to
We have got a kind of a session tomorrow, the art of storytelling. And that is, you should not miss it out, all of you. And I think Ms. Sajan is absolutely
right. Much request session. Much request session. Put our kids to sleep ourselves. Sar pe haath laga ke unko kahani bolo. They will go off to sleep, then wake them up in the morning. Whatever practice they are adopting now, they'll follow it for the rest of their life. They should have the breakfast by 8 o'clock. They should have the lunch by 12 o'clock. They should have snack by 4 o'clock. And by 6:30, they should stop their food at all. Food. How to get them interested in vegetables? The child doesn't know what is good and what is bad, no? Because they are child. So if you have the feeling that the child is not going to have vegetable, they will not have. So experiment with few vegetable. And of course, obviously the child is going to find something which is of taste to them. So experiment them with those sort of vegetables. And lead by example. If we ourselves are having burger and pasta and things like that, don't expect the kid to build it. Khud jab khane lagenge to loge, at least for a curiosity, they might have that. Mama, aap kya kha rahe ho? Aap roz ye vegetable kha rahe ho? Aap beta ye badhiya, tum bhi kha ke aasma ke dekh lo. It happens like that. It's a very slow process. There's no magic bullet for it. It's a slow process, but whatever they follow now, that is what they're going to live with for the rest of their life.
Yes, absolutely. I think we learned a lot from Ms. Sajan today. We learned about how to be healthy and how to be fit, and also learned about a proper diet and how to be immune at time of COVID. We also learned what kind of a water quantity and what kind of a rice quantity we should have. And of course, according to each one, I say that each one take one, means each one has got a different metabolism and each one has got different kind of issues. So I think according to your own thing, what fits you, you can do that, but everything to limit. So that's what he was telling. So now a take home message for everyone, Ms. Sajan, a quick kind of a recap of whatever you said so that everyone can just note it down and said, these are the few mantras which you're going to tell them. And this will actually be lifelong. They'll follow this so that they avoid all kind of diseases and all kind of health issues which might come to them after middle age or maybe before middle age.
In order of preference and sequentially, I will put sleep on top of the pyramid. I think sleep is fundamentally the most important thing and most important process of living an healthy lifestyle. So sleep comes first, and 7 hours of sleep to 8 hours of sleep is mandatory. There is no negotiation and no compromise on that. You have to sleep early, get up early. Eat clean, be mindful of the choices you make when it comes to your diet. Be very mindful. And occasional indulgence, no problem at all. But don't make that the norm. Avoid processed, packaged, and preserved food. Avoid deep fried food. Avoid aerated drinks. Drink 3 to 4 liters of water every single day. Okay? When the sun comes down, stop eating. Start do IF 12-hour window. Initially, gradually you can pick up pace. Your energy levels will be high. Your confidence will increase. Your self-esteem will increase. You will be a positive person and you will be happy from within. When we are going to die, our BMW car is not going to go inside our 6 feet land. Our bungalow will also not go. Our bank balance will also not go. Akele aaya tha, akele jana hai. So, ye paisa ka aur ye mere ko paisa bahut kamana hai. Iske piche mein bahut bhago. So, be married to a process. Process pe dhyan rakho, process ko enjoy karo. As a family, take a vacation to a farm or to a village and take your children and show them what is real life. 70% of India's population lives in rural. We are a poor country because our per capita income is 2,000 rupees per person, whereas the per capita income of New York is $64,000. 90% of our productivity comes from informal sectors. You understand how is a country, how we are. So we are showing the children the city and the big life and all this thing. But true India lives in the villages. Take them to the villages. Go back to basics. What our grandmother and grandfather did, they lived for 100 years. Do that. Tell stories to your children. Walk. Wherever you can walk, walk. Ab marenge nahi. Koi marenge nahi. 2 kilometers chalega to koi marega nahi. You will live long if you walk 2 kilometers. But if you take your vehicle and go out, then you may live less. Most of these diseases can be eliminated by adopting a lifestyle which can be sustained for a long period of time. If you want to avoid going to doctors and throwing away your hard-earned money, I have not fallen sick in the last 2 decades. I've never taken a sick leave till now. Okay? Why? Because mind. Everything is in the mind. I'll tell you one small story and end my session. Once Akbar went to a war. Akbar won the war. Akbar got a prisoner from the war and Akbar told the prisoner, I'm sending you to the gallows. So the prisoner started negotiating with Akbar. Akbar, please don't send me to the gallows. Give me 6 months' time, I will make your horse fly. Akbar said, you will make my horse fly? Prisoner said, yes, I'll make your horse fly. Akbar thought for a while and said, okay, I grant you 6 months' time and send him to the cell. When he went to the cell, the fellow prisoner asked him, in 6 months' time, you will make Akbar's horse fly. How? The prisoner said, 6 months, 4 things can happen. Akbar may change his mind. Akbar may die. Horse may die. And who knows? Horse may fly. So we are living in a world of endless possibilities. If I can reduce 21 kgs in 3 months, and at the age of 40 years, transition into be India's top long-distance runners, and run distances which humanly people think it is impossible, there is never a late time to start late. The right time is now and the right day is now. Your life is in your control. You have to take control of the steering, which is your health. Thank you.
I loved your motivational talk and the way you spoke, Ms. Sajan, it was so motivating. Yes, the horse will fly. And I think today is the day when we have to change our lifestyle. And today is the day when we have to take an oath of, starting a life anew. So that's what I try to put it all together. And I remember that very well, that when a person whom I met, and he said, I was traveling with Professor Narayan Murthy of Infosys. And he said that all my life I've been making money, but I didn't take care of my knee. And today my knee is giving a problem. So that's what I think. I take a cue from Mr. Sajan Samuel's talk, saying that our health is more important than our wealth. And our health is more important than our work. So put your health as a priority. And let's, from today, make a new kind of a lifestyle. And let's show that, yes, I'm here to live for myself and not for the world. So that's very important. So with that, Ms. Sajan, I thank you so much. And I thank all the people who asked questions on the Zoom group chat and on the Facebook. And we have put the Facebook recording. You can see what Ms. Sajan spoke And I think he did a wonderful session with us today. So thank you so much for your time, Ms. Sajan. He's at Pune, not at Bangalore, and he's a very busy man. And he took out so much time to be with us today. So I really thank you, Ms. Sajan. Yes.
Thank you. Thanks. Bye-bye. Bye.
Thank you.